Okay, so welcome back. In this class, we're going to look at how to change the view options within WPS Office Suite. So to start changing the view options, because it's important to have the different views and introduce different features that can help you maximize your productivity within WPS Office Suite. All you need is just to come to view options over here, and you can view the document in full screen mode with just the selection of full screen. And everything is now full screen. You can see the percentage of the zoom level. This is now 130%. If you want, you can increase or decrease it from here just directly by clicking this 170, but you can keep increasing, or you can go back and decrease, and you can quit the full screen mode over here by just clicking on quit screen. And this is the default, which is the print layout. This is the outline view, which is the one that you can see how the arrangement of the document in stages and including the levels, this outline view, and have other things to play around with at the outline view. You can always close if you are done, but still within the view options, you can check the web view. This is web page view. Okay, this is a web page view. In cases, if you want to see the web page view of your document, you can always come over here. And there's this navigation pane. You can enable it if you want. So let's go back to the page print layout, and then we can try to show the navigation pane. Navigation pane is actually important if you have it within your left or right of the document. You can just, within a click, it will take you to a particular section that you're working on directly. With just a click, it's just going to give you a preview of whatever you have within this document. And over here, you can enable the pages. Okay, so you can be able to move from page to page just like so. You can just navigate around. So it just gives you that ease of access to navigate around within your document. And you can bookmark things, or you can bookmark pages, and you will be able to see all the bookmark that you've made within the document over here. And you can search the document for a particular keyword or for a particular page or anything within that particular document. Okay, so let's come back to the main navigation pane, and you can go back to the view options as well. And then you can check out, you can enable the ruler. Okay, if you want to enable the ruler, you can see it. So let's close the navigation pane. You can see the ruler that enables you to know the width, or if you want to increase, play around with the margins, you can do that with the ruler as well. And you can see it both left and at the top and at the sides. Okay, so you can be able to adjust accordingly the margins or the arrangement in the document. You can enable markup if you want, and you can check out view grid lines. If you want to enable grid lines to your pages, you can just, with just one click, you can have grid lines enabled. And if you want, don't want, you can disable, and you can have the task flow where if you want to restrict editing of your document, or you want to set in another preference, you can always set from here. Now close, and you can have table of grid lines in cases if you want to have. And you can zoom in from here, or you can leave it 100% with just a simple click, or you can play around and make it full width. It should take the entire full width of the document. With just a simple click, you'll be able to have the access to that, and you can navigate and come back to the 100% zoom feature. And then you can make it one page. Right now it's one page. If you want to make it multiple page, you can see it's now multiple pages. So everything is now converted to multiple pages. You can see them very easily. And you can go back to one page if you want. And this is the eye protection mode in cases when you want to minimize the rays coming out, the reflection from the screen. You can use the eye protection mode, so there is little impact on your eyes when you use the eye reflection mode. You can rearrange the document with horizontal text box, or you can do cascading. You can do all that, or you can enable new windows. If you want to create a new window, you can just with just a simple click, or you can split the window if you want into two, just something like that. And you can cancel the splitting, or you can remove the new window if you so wish. Okay, so this is the document. It just gives you another new tab, because in WPS you can have multiple of tabs that you can be working with simultaneously within a particular document. So let's remove the eye protection mode, and you can view side by side a particular document. Okay, so you can view side by side this one and this one, and you can scroll accordingly. Right now you can see you can scroll individually. The scrolling has been synchronized. They will scroll together. If you want, you can off the synchronization and be able to synchronize only one page and be able to compare with the other page over here. Okay, so you can synchronize them individually, and you can reset the position if you want. If you don't want the side by side, all you need is just to click it. Okay, click it out. So I think this does it for this tutorial on how to check out the view options to be able to enhance your productivity within the Microsoft WPS Office Suite. In our next class, we're going to look at how to add cover page to your document to make it look professional for submitting or for any presentation to a third party. So until next time, thanks for watching, and I look forward to seeing you in the next class. Bye.